researchers use chromatin immunoprecipitation, or ChIP, to identify and characterize protein-DNA interactions in the context of chromatin. ChIP experiments can use variant input samples, chromatin fragmentation methods, and provide ChIP-qPCR or ChIP-seq readouts. The success of your ChIP experiment depends on the fragmentation of chromatin, a critical step in the ChIP protocol. This can be accomplished with either sonication or enzymatic digestion. But how do you decide which chromatin fragmentation protocol to use in your ChIP experiments? A number of factors can influence your choice, making a decision seem daunting. So let's simplify. Cell signaling technology will show you the way. In this video, we'll walk through four questions that will help you find a protocol and the ideal ChIP kit from cell signaling technology that's suited to your experimental needs. First, what is your input sample type? Cells or tissues? Second, what type of protein is being targeted for immunoprecipitation? Histones, transcription factors, and cofactors bind to DNA with varying strength, affecting ChIP efficiency. Other factors to consider are the abundance of the target protein in your sample and your preferred method for chromatin fragmentation. In many instances, you can use either sonication or enzymatic digestion. We'll also introduce some scenarios in which one method for chromatin fragmentation outperforms the other. Traditional sonication protocols use harsh denaturing conditions. Cell signaling technology scientists have developed specially formulated lysis buffers to protect chromatin integrity and antibody epitopes. This enables you to obtain more reliable results when analyzing transcription factors and cofactors using our ChIP kits. Let's walk through the scenario in which your input samples are cells. If you are looking at histones or high abundance transcription factors or cofactors, both sonication and enzymatic digestion work well. Select a simple ChIP kit based on your chromatin fragmentation preference. While sonication can be used with low abundance transcription factors and cofactors, enzymatic digestion is preferred. The protein-DNA interactions for these proteins are more labile and may be prone to loss in sonication. For optimal results, we recommend using enzymatic fragmentation as a first choice. Next, we'll consider tissues and how the type of tissue may affect how you choose a ChIP protocol. If you are performing ChIP with any type of tissue, it's critical to homogenize the input material to a single-cell suspension prior to nuclear lysis and chromatin fragmentation. Simple ChIP Plus kits for both sonication and enzymatic protocols are approved for use with most tissue types, including liver, brain, and heart. If you are looking at histones, high abundance transcription factors, or high abundance cofactors in these tissues, you can select either of these kits. For optimal ChIP results with low abundance transcription factors and cofactors from these tissues, we recommend using the enzymatic protocol. Note that especially fibrous tissues like skeletal muscle and fatty adipose tissues are more difficult to homogenize. A tissue-specific protocol is required to homogenize these samples into single-cell suspensions prior to chromatin fragmentation. For these fibrous or fatty tissues, cell signaling technology recommends using the sonication protocol with the Simple ChIP Plus Sonication Chromatin IP kit for all target types. Sonication is more effective than enzymatic digestion due to the significant force required to break apart these tissues and lyse through cells and nuclei. No matter your ChIP assay requirements, the family of Simple ChIP kits from cell signaling technology can enable your experimental success. Once you've found your kit, we recommend using a ChIP-validated antibody whenever possible. Every ChIP-validated antibody from cell signaling technology has been tested by scientists on our ChIP team using cell signaling technology simple ChIP kits. Anytime you have a question about a ChIP antibody, kit, or protocol, the scientists on our ChIP team are here to help. Get in touch at cellsignal.com/support.